Greece, Mountain Olympus. Correctly, it is called Mount Olympus. It is the highest mountain in Greece, with 2,918 meters. In ancient times, Mount Olympus was used by extraterrestrials as a base. The ancient Greek civilizations worshipped those extraterrestrials as gods and viewed these mountains as sacred. In this episode, I will visit the ruins of the ancient city DION next to the mountain, and I will walk up to the middle of the mountain for a lightwork meditation. Mountains have many crystals inside. They are like batteries for cosmic energy. Follow me in this wisdom tour to get charged by the energy of Mount Olympus and the ancient temples. Receive information for a healthy life and use these affirmations and meditation to be in tune with light and love of the cosmic awareness. In the confusing and negative society of planet Earth, it is important to keep the focus on light and love and keep the connection to the nature in order to be healthy physically, mentally and spiritually. It is important to do light work and create higher frequencies of light and love until negative energies are removed. If you are living in cities far away from the nature, you can use this movie to get charged with the healing energy of the nature in Dion, the mountain Olympus and the meditation at the end. The healing energy is embedded in this movie for everybody who is open for healing energies and is watching with a loving heart. Places with positive energy can help to charge with energy of light and therefore do light work more effectively. This time, I visited Mountain Olympus in Greece and the ancient city Dion next to the mountain to charge with the positive energies of this place. The positive energies are there because they have been accumulated over thousands of years at this place, and they were not damaged by modern society because it is kept natural and untouched like a natural park without masses of tourists. Around 2,500 years ago, Dion was located next to the big river Vafiras that was connected to the sea, so it was possible to visit the city by boat. Today there is not much left from the water on the surface, but there is still water running underground and there are many swamps. Dion was used like a sanctuary and wellness center, with temples for meditation, baths, music and art. It was like a park with many trees, fruits, a lake and animals. When you walk here, you feel immediately a healing and relaxing energy. Follow me as I'm walking around and keep your focus on feeling and receiving the healing energies of Dion. Dion was dedicated to the extraterrestrial Zeus and the Muses. The name Zeus is actually a wrong English translation, because correctly he is called Zeus. In the Greek language, E and U is pronounced like a W in the word wisdom. Zeus was the leader of the extraterrestrials who had a base in the mountain Olympus. In Greece, they have two names for this leader. One name was Zeus and the other one was Theas. The name of the city Dion comes from Theas and means that this city belongs to Theas. In ancient Greece, they were worshipping these extraterrestrials as gods because they saw them all the time flying around the mountain Olympus and because they did not understand technology and thought it's a form of magic. Because of this, they kept Dion a sacred place and they built temples close to the mountain to worship the extraterrestrials. The temple of Zeus or Theas was next to the river and the water was used not only for drinking but also for healing and cleansing the body before entering any temple. For over 600 years, Dion was a place where people focused on healing and art, until at the end earthquakes destroyed the buildings and the river flooded the ruins with water and mud. The temples had to be excavated after over 2,500 years of mud and vegetation. In front of the temple of Zeus, they found the remains of a statue of Zeus and the offering altar stone with carvings of eagles, the symbol of Zeus. Today outside, they have put copies of the statues, and the original statues can be seen in the museum close by. The statue of Zeus shows him holding a staff in the left hand and an energy device in the right hand. In other places in Greece, this statue of Zeus was found in better condition, so we can see how the statue looked like. Next to the temple of Dios is the temple of the Egyptian extraterrestrial Isis. In the beginning of DION, this temple used to be a sanctuary for the extraterrestrials Artemis and Aphrodite. Hundreds of years later, they built on top of them a temple to worship the Egyptian extraterrestrial Isis, but they left one part with the statue of Aphrodite. So under the visible ruins, there are much older ruins. The energy here at the temples of Zeus and Isis is very calm because people were coming here over 600 years to meditate. Even when they thought that these extraterrestrials are gods, the energy is still good because everybody was focusing on positive things and they were keeping the places sacred, clean and free from negative energies. They built the temples outside of the main center of the city in the living space. So the energy at the temples was always high and clean. When you visited the temples in ancient Greece, first you had to clean yourself physically and energetically before you enter the temples. The temples that were built next to the water of the river had even more energy because a flowing, moving water is constantly refreshing energies. Especially in a time when there was no industrial pollution, the energies of nature were even more powerful. The energies of the nature are influencing the aura of the body and are keeping the physical body and the consciousness healthy. Next to the temple of Dios and Isis is the temple of the extraterrestrial Demeter. In English language, the name is wrong translated as Demeter. But the correct name is Demeter. Demeter was worshipped in Greece as the goddess of the harvest and agriculture and the giver of grain. In ancient art, Demeter was pictured wearing a wreath made of ears of corn. One of the famous stories about Demeter is depicted on many Greek vases. This painting tells a story about Demeter and Triptolemus. Triptolemus was another extraterrestrial who helped Demeter in a time when she was sad. She was very grateful for Triptolemus, and as a gift she gave Triptolemus the knowledge about agriculture, and she allowed him to travel to the Earth humans and give them this knowledge too. Extraterrestrials had always the law that is not allowed to interfere in the natural development of Earth humans, unless in rare cases that were for essential and necessary knowledge. So Demeter allowed Triptolemus to give Earth humans the knowledge of agriculture, and she gave him a spaceship to fly to many places of the Earth and teach. As I said in past episode, the spaceships in ancient art were always depicted as chariots with wings and snakes, because in those times, people did not understand technology and depicted everything with something they knew. So we can see depictions of Ilios, which is the Greek word for sun, or the extraterrestrial Apollo, flying with their glowing spacecrafts that were not understood by Earth humans. In the painting of Demeter and Triptolemus, the wings are symbolizing that the craft could fly, and the snakes are symbolizing the cosmic energy that was radiating around the ship. The frequencies and energies of magnetic energy are moving in zigzag form and spiral form, and this form reminds the people of the form of a snake. That is why in ancient times, all cultures were using the snake form as a symbol for energy movement. I filmed the symbol also in Mexico, in Teotihuacan, at the Kukulcan Pyramid. Chichen Itza, where again it is symbolizing the cosmic energy at the pyramids. The same energy symbol of the snake are filmed in Sri Lanka, where it is depicted on many ancient temples. Most of these temples were built to worship the extraterrestrials who landed with their spaceships, so they built even real-sized copies of the ships. Today they call them stupas, but originally, thousands of years ago, they were depicting landed spacecrafts. And the extraterrestrials inside were worshipped by Earth humans as gods too. In the Museum of DION, we can see a rare exception of the depiction of spaceships. In the excavations, they found a stone carving of Dimitra, showing a spaceship over her head. This is not a head, as some people would think. The artist is telling symbolically that Dimitra or other extraterrestrials had visited the people by using these flying spacecrafts. The same spaceship we can see at depictions from extraterrestrial Hermes, or correctly named Hermes. Hermes was the most famous extraterrestrial in Greece, who was flying with their spaceship to Earth humans, and he was called the messenger of the gods from Olympus. So he was always depicted with a winged spaceship and winged shoes, symbolizing that he was flying. On the stone carving of Dimitra in the spaceship, we can also see that in her left hand she is holding an energy staff, a device that was used to use cosmic energy. It's the same energy staff that we can see in Egyptian paintings and stone carvings. In the Museum of Dion, we can see how advanced Greece was 2,500 years ago in art and beauty, in a time where other places in Europe had still barbaric warriors and wandering nomads without any sense of art, philosophy or engineering. The depiction of human statues in every realistic detail was only seen in Greece and shows an advanced knowledge of proportions and three-dimensional imagination. Hundreds of years later, the Italian Romans stole in wars many of the statues and started to copy the style, but without the special energy that is radiating from the art, because the Italian Romans were mainly warriors and only interested in conquering other countries. Here we can see a millstone and fruit press that was found in the Temple of Isis. In the Temple of Isis, we also found these stone plates with footprints or ears. They were created by pilgrims who were visiting the temples as a visible sign and proof that they were here and as a thanking for a safe return home. These statues were found at the Temple of Dimitra. A rare and unusual find in the museum is a bronze hydravlis, or hydraulic musical pipe organ. That is the world's first music keyboard instrument that was invented by the Greek Hesivios around 2,350 years ago. His wife was the first music keyboard player in history. Hundreds of years later, the Byzantine emperor sent one hydravlis instrument to Rome as a gift, and it developed into the church organ with air pressure and later to the modern electrical music keyboard of today. Hydravlis is an ancient Greek word and means pipe of water. Hydro means water in ancient Greek, and avlos means pipe. Hydravlis is the root word for the English word hydraulic. These statues show the children of the healer Asclepius. Here we can see different objects of the daily life, like oil lamps, small statues, a small statue of the extraterrestrial Hermes with the spaceship symbol the winged helmet, and the energy staff Kirikyo. Here we can see accessories of clothing, scissors and needles, and iron tools for sculpture art. Art was very developed in ancient Greece, even more than today. Art was a way to express beauty and create a loving atmosphere. The society of today is degenerated so much that thinks that ugliness is art. But in ancient times, they used real art of beauty, and they used it everywhere, in every space of living, even in bathrooms. DION had very advanced baths, because it was a wellness place. They had an underground heating system to keep the pools and the floor warm. They were using fire in a big oven that was heating up many stones in an underground room, so the stones stayed warm for a long time. They were using the clean water of the river in an advanced water system and were directing the water with channels in all parts of the city. They had even public toilets connected to the water system. This was even more advanced than other European countries in the Middle Age of the 1800s, where people were living in dirt and stench like rats, and therefore had diseases and contention like the pest disease. Every wall and every floor in the baths was decorated with art to please the eyes and the soul. The mosaic art on the floor alone is an act of meditation and creation of beauty and positive energies. In those times, people knew that art and beauty is important for staying in a loving energy and developing the consciousness and the soul. It is the opposite of today, where buildings are cold, ugly and emotionless, like they are made from robots, and they are creating an atmosphere of depression and low negative energy that is not moving. In the city of DION, they had a main road with private houses and shops on each side. Every building was decorated with colors and statues and was a piece of art itself. When you walk in this archaeological site, you feel the calm, healing energy of those past times. You get charged with the energy of the mountain Olympus, the energy of thousands of past meditations, and the energy of the nature. This place is never experiencing masses of tourists. That is why the energy is still powerful and clean. When you are sensitive for energies, you can feel the energy even through the movie recording. You can feel how the people were walking happy through the forest and eating the fruits of the nature that had the full potential of cosmic energy, because they were not sprayed with poison like in the modern society of today. There is still a natural lake visible today where animals are enjoying the clean energy. The water of the river is flowing through small channels and creeks through all DION, and because of this, the water movement is constantly charging the environment with fresh cosmic energy. The society in ancient Greece 2,500 years ago and older was more developed than the modern society of today, because they were living more in tune with the nature. They may not have the technology of today, but they were more wise and more developed about real feelings, spirituality, art and philosophy. There was no TV craziness and no internet craziness. No partner was putting thousands of self pictures in some internet to flirt with others and hurt the partner. There were no chemicals in food and no pollution in the air. The aura was more clean and had more light radiating. Negative people were only a minority and not as insane as today. DION was radiating light for over 600 years, but unfortunately, in the ending period of DION, negative people came from outside and destroyed the city. Then there was a period when the Italian-Roman military came and occupied DION for a short time. This negative energy attracted many earthquakes and floods and destroyed the buildings of DION. So the people moved out of DION to other places and DION was abundant. So the planet cleansed this spot and kept the positive energies protected. That is why DION is still radiating a strong energy of light. You feel a warm energy is flowing in your body and heart, and you feel charged and healed. When you are sensitive for energies, you feel like you are walking inside of a frequency that exists in another time. Close to the lake was the healing temple of Asclepius. If you remember from previous episodes, I had light work in two other Asclepius temples. Asclepius, the son of the extraterrestrial Apollo, was a healer and doctor who had many healing temples at many places in Greece. These temples were places of meditation, healing, and teaching esoteric wisdom. The word esoteric comes from the Greek word esoterika and means inside. The opposite is the word exoterika and means outside. The word exoterika is the root for the word exit that is used in the English language. In ancient times, the temples in Greece were always built at energy points, at places with a higher cosmic energy. This natural cosmic energy of the Earth was helping to heal negative energies of the mind and body. I stayed here for a long time, and I enjoyed the natural sounds and the powerful energy. Try to feel the healing energies as you watch the recording. Now that we are charged by the cosmic energy of DION, let's have a meditation walk on the mountain Olympus and talk about healing blockades and diseases in order to create a life of love and joy. The energy of the mountain is embedded in this video, so open your heart to receive the natural cosmic energy. Very often, blockades and negative mind patterns are stored in the soul and are carried in each life if we don't listen to the talk of the soul in order to heal them. Many people on Earth are programming themselves unconsciously with negative, limiting mind patterns and affirmations for many years or many lives, and are blocking themselves to live a healthy, happy life. Thoughts, words, and feelings are energy and have an impact in our life. Negative thoughts are the cause for many negative energies like diseases, disappointments, or wars on this planet. There are people who focus only in what the dark side is doing and watch only videos about negative extraterrestrials. These people miss the meaning of life, and they are actually supporting the energy of the dark side because they don't create any positive energy. So we have to change our thoughts and emotions if we want to change negative things on this planet. Sometimes this takes a long time to change something and manifest a better situation. It is rare that something changes in one day. It depends on many things. It depends on how much cosmic love energy you are using for what you want and how long. It depends if you have negative karma from past lives that needs to be erased first. And it depends if you are living in a negative environment where negative energies make you sick and are blocking you to use positive energies. Some people have many layers of negative karma from many past lives. They have many layers because they never worked on cleansing them. So after many lives, there is a heavy load of negative karma and negative energies, and it takes more time to clean these layers. As I say in my videos, deleting one layer is not enough. You need to clean all the layers of negative energies until they are not blocking you anymore in this life. As I say in my videos, you can delete negative karma by creating positive karma with positive deeds and with real cosmic love energy in the heart and consciousness. This energy has to be real and not fake. You cannot cheat in front of the cosmic consciousness, the source, the energy called God. Any form of negativity, ego, arrogance, pride, jealousy, or hate will create more negative karma, more diseases, more negative extraterrestrials, more natural disasters as a cleansing. And there will be no smooth transformation on planet Earth as long as the majority of Earth humans is not using the natural universal cosmic energy of light and love. As I say in my movies, life is a learning process and each planet is a school. It depends on our individual choice, our will and our thoughts, if we learn fast or slow. Any life lesson, experience and wisdom that you, the soul, missed in this life, you will catch up, rectify or repeat in the next life. That is why a soul has many millions of lives on many different planets and dimensions. One life is not enough to gain experience, knowledge and wisdom. If you don't know this essential knowledge, you don't know what life is, and you don't develop because you don't work on yourself and your character. In these cases, the soul is creating some shocking situations to wake up the sleeping rational mind. You cannot heal a disease by just trying to patch the surface. This is not real healing because the real reason is not healed. If you don't heal the symptom, the real reason of a disease, logically, the disease will come back again one day. The real reason of a disease is always negative energy. And if this negative energy is not healed, it will manifest over time in a physical form. We need positive energy in order to heal the cause, the reason, the root of the disease. Only then we are really healing. As I said many times, everything you see in the physical reality is only the condensed condition of energy. Everything is manifested energy. The cause of everything is fine matter energy. Everything you see in the physical reality is only the condensed condition of energy. Because most Earth humans have negative thoughts and emotions, the society on Earth is negative and chaotic. An energy can manifest itself into a physical form. Diseases are coming mostly from negative energies, negative thoughts, or suppressed unhealed emotions, who have not been healed and have manifested as a physical disease and are causing a physical dysfunction. Diseases are also coming from unhealthy, contaminated, genetic manipulated food, or from eating animal corpses and their fear energies, hormones and diseases, or from drinking alcohol and smoking, or from negative karmic issues. Fine matter energy is the cause of any chemical or electrical process in the body. High energy keeps the body healthy, and low energy keeps the body sick. Aggressiveness, hate, fear, or sadness is keeping your energy low. It is altering the molecular structure of the body, making the body weak, and it's causing heart attacks, cancer, rheumatism, inflammation and other diseases. So it is wise to avoid evil people, stress, drugs or unhealthy food. Go often to nature to clean your body from negative energies. With a high frequency of cosmic love, you can transform all negative energies. If you use enough cosmic love energy, every disease can be healed at the energy level in the course. Cosmic universal love is the solution for everything, because it is the energy of the cosmic awareness, the energy called God. If you don't have enough light energy, you can use the help of natural herbs too. As I say in my movies, the cause in every natural disease is always in the energy level, and if you don't heal it there, it manifests in the physical level. You always have to think about what the body is trying to tell you. Let's take a look at some examples of common diseases on Earth and why fine matter energy is the cause of any chemical or electrical process in the body. And at the end, I will give you a guided healing meditation. Eye problems. Eye problems indicates that you don't want to see something in life or you cannot see. Have you ever wondered why even small children have eye problems and need glasses? The reason is, these children don't want to see the negative things in this Earth society or in the family. and so the eyes get energetically disturbed and eventually physical. The energy of the feelings and thoughts have an effect on the physical body. People with glasses have some inner spiritual blockades that they don't want to see, and they need to heal them. It means that they cannot see the reality as it is, or they don't want to see something, or they don't like to see their lives. Nearsightedness indicates that somebody has fear of the future. So you need to be in tune with the flow of the cosmic awareness and trust the source of light. Nearsightedness is also a problem of the modern society, where everybody is looking almost all day on computers and phones. That makes the eyes get used to look only in a short distance and lose the ability to see far away. So it is important to look at faraway objects. You have to train your eyes when you go outside to look far away and close, back and forth. Farsightedness indicates that somebody has fear of the present and he is not living in the now. He always looks at the past fears or future fears. If someone has problems with his eyes, like strabismus or squint, then there is something he don't want to see or is afraid of, and he should meditate about it and create self-love in order to heal the energy, the cause. In addition, on the physical level, you can use the plant Euphrasia officinalis. You can use it as eye drops, or you can make a tea of it and bathe your eyes with it in order to heal inflammation, blurred vision, and eye fatigue. An inflammation in the eyes shows that somebody has anger and is disappointed about what he sees in life. The same applies to dry eyes. Ear problems. A problem with the ears shows that your soul is trying to warn you that you have to learn to listen to the inner voice. Focus more to the voice of your soul and not on negative energies or people from your environment. I'm talking about this in all my videos. Any problem with ears is caused by refusing to listen to the truth of the source, the soul, to the love. Eventually, when the person is arrogant, egoistic, or has negative thoughts, the soul is trying to warn the person with a problem in the ear. Thoughts and feelings are energy, and if they are negative, they are making a person sick. It is a frequency of the source, the cosmic awareness, that is trying to tell you that you are blocking the spiritual flow of cosmic love. This person has to meditate and concentrate on what is it that I don't want to hear. You can use these affirmations. I am open to hear anything that life is trying to tell me. I allow the love in my heart to heal me. A high-pitched sound once in a year in the ear means that the body adapts to higher energies and frequencies, and in that moment, it's good to support this adjustment with meditation. Nose bleeding. When the nose is bleeding, it means that you have the desire for recognition. You're feeling overlooked and not recognized. You are crying out of love. It's a sign for missing self-esteem. So you have to learn to love yourself and see that you are part of the existence and therefore precious. Your true self is your soul, and your soul is pure energy because it's part of the source, the cosmic awareness. Throat problems. Breathing stands for breathing the cosmic energy of life. It means you allow life to go inside you and be part of you. If you have breathing problems, you don't allow fully the energy of life in your body, and you have a lack of self-love. If you have problems with the throat, like inflammation or stuttering, it means that the throat chakra has an energetic blockade. It means there is a psychological blockade. There are four reasons for that blockade. Reason number one, it means that there is a blockade because of others have programmed you to be quiet. You are not able to speak for yourself, to have your own opinion, to speak the truth. You have not the courage to express yourself. Reason number two, it can also mean that the blockade is there because you have to learn first to treat people nice. After you learn to talk to people with real love out of the heart, the blockade will disappear. Reason number three, because of withholding anger. Reason number 4, because you refuse to change yourself. Tonsillitis shows that the throat chakra and the immune system is energetically weak and therefore infected by bacteria. A blockade in the throat chakra comes when one does not dare to say something, or if you believe that you are not worth to say anything, or if you swallow anger. One should learn to talk bravely, but with friendly words. If you talk without love, you are creating even more blockades in your life. Send the light of love to the throat and tell to yourself that you will start to talk positive and powerful. In addition, you can use natural herbs like prunella vulgaris tea, chamomile tea, melissa officinalis tea. Blood pressure. A high blood pressure indicates unhealed emotional problems that you need to let go of them. These emotional problems are either from this life or from past lives. Practice meditation to get wisdom from your soul and higher self. Additionally, you can take these herbs for high blood pressure. Valerian, wild garlic, ginkgo, ginseng, lettuce, passion flower, or hawthorn. A low blood pressure indicates that you did not get enough love as a child or in the last life, and you are pessimistic. So you need self-love, and you have to decide to live in the now. Additionally, you can take these herbs for low blood pressure. Nettle, rosemary, beetroot, or thyme tea. Heart problems. All heart problems have something to do with emotional problems like missing joy, stress, sadness, anger, hate, fear. You have to get rid of all these lower energies and charge yourself with a higher energy. This high energy is called cosmic love. Use this affirmation a few months. Love and joy is flowing through my heart. Diabetes. People with diabetes have lost the sweetness of life and are longing to have it back. They have sorrow and grief. That is why most of them are smoking, drinking alcohol, eating too much, have too much stress, because they try to compensate the energy loss and emptiness. But that makes diabetes even worse, and they can get heart attacks and arteriosclerosis. They think that life is not sweet anymore, and therefore the body creates too much sugar in the system. In this case, they need to learn to see the good things in life and be thankful for anything good they have in life, no matter how small or big it is. They have to trust in life again, trust in the existence and in their life plan. Trust that everything in life has a reason, and they have to look what the lesson is they have to learn and solve. If a soul don't solve it in this life, they have to solve it in the next life. That's why there are even babies born with diabetes. If somebody has too low sugar in the body, it indicates that the person has a low energy level and a low will of life. This person thinks that everything in life is difficult and he can't handle it. The thoughts of this person have manifested a difficult life with difficult situations. That person needs to change their way of thinking in order to change the manifestations in life. This person needs to be open for the abundance that is coming from the cosmic awareness and allow himself to receive no matter when and no matter how. People with diabetes have to use the affirmation, I love myself, I trust the existence, and I'm open to experience the sweetness of life. They have to exercise their body and get rid of stress. In addition, it's good to eat green beans, nettle, elecampane tea, blueberry, elderberry tea, potatoes, and burdock. Weight problems. Weight problems indicate that someone cannot let go of the past or past energies, past negative emotions and thoughts, sorrow, sadness and pain, and is still holding on to them. It indicates also that someone has a lack of loving sexuality and true inner joy. Energy is the cause of everything, and it has an influence on the chemical processes of the physical body. Many people eat too much because they use food as a substitute for missing love. They don't get enough love energy from others, and this is making them feel sad and empty. They try to fill the inner emptiness with food in order to feel better, especially with sweets and junk food. Eating too much sweets is a substitute for missing love. Others are using smoking and alcohol. Cosmic love and self-love can heal this problem because love is the highest frequency of the existence that is able to heal and transform everything. With love, you change your thoughts, you change your energy, and therefore you change your behavior and attract other people with positive energies. Stomach problems. Stomach problems indicate fears or anger and an energetic blockade in the solar plexus energy point. Stomach problems show that you can't digest some things in life. So you have to learn to focus on your life plan and be in flow with the energy of light. The energy of light can show you solutions, but you have to be open to see the solutions. Bladder problems. Bladder problems are a sign for fears, inner anger, sticking in old negative thoughts and emotions, and not accepting new things in life. Kidney problems. An infection in the kidneys shows that someone has a lack of self-love. Somebody who feels disappointed and angry like a child. The kidneys are filtering toxins and negative emotions out of the blood and are regulating the water in the body. If you have too much negative emotions, like anger, it will manifest stones in the kidneys. You have to keep the kidneys warm, physically and emotionally, with real love. If they get cold, they get an infection, and they cannot filter everything. So sometimes you lose blood through the urine. It happens more often to women than to men. Every once a while, humans have to detoxify the kidneys. The nature has plans for this. Birch, beer grape, barberry, beans, watercress, and chaga tea. Parkinson's disease problem. Parkinson is an indication for fear and trying to escape from something or someone. The solution is the energy of real cosmic love, meditation, self-love, trust in the existence, and being in tune with it. Stroke. Stroke can happen to people with heavy stress or with a stubborn, egoistic mind who want to control everything and everybody. People who don't trust the flow or changes of the cosmic awareness won't rather die than change their behavior and thinking. They have to learn to adjust to the changes, developments, and transformations in life. They have to learn the natural state of being in tune with the existence, in tune with cosmic love energy. Legs and feet problems. The legs are the symbol for moving on. If there's a problem with the legs or feet, you may have fear of the future, fear of moving on. In any case of inflammation, you can use the natural Boswellia serrata pills. Restless legs indicates that you have internal stress and unrest because something is bothering you in your life or something scares you. Negative energies in the environment in which you live can cause this nervousness. A lack of sleep or too much coffee and sweets produce too much nervousness too. If you have anxiety, you have to calm down again with meditation. In meditation, you can find the cause of the trouble and remove it that way. Additional help for relaxation comes from the plant St. John's Wort. Cancer problem. As I say in each episode, thoughts and emotions are energy and are creating our environment and health situation. Cancer can be manifested with negative energies like hatred, anger, envy, resentment, deep sadness, feeling hurt, depression, or smoking and alcohol. So the first thing you have to do to heal yourself is to create real cosmic love energy in your heart and forgive the problem from the past and clean any negative karma that you have created. Then you have to start loving yourself and that means you take care of yourself. If you have accomplished this, you will be able to act with real love to others and create positive karma. In addition, you can use anti-cancer herbs like artichoke, valerian, birch, carrot, garlic, cabbage, milk thistle, parsley, marigold, chives, juniper, hawthorn, cinnamon, onion, Siberian ginseng, and jaga tea. Drink beetroot, take enzymes and vitamins. Smoking drugs addiction. Smoking of any kind is indicating a lack of self-love and manipulation from lower astral entities or demons. Drugs and alcohol are opening channels and doors to the lower astral worlds, where demons and non-spiritual people are existing, as long as they use negative energy. Just because you see with drugs those lower worlds, it does not mean that you are spiritual. It shows only that you opened a door for negative entities that you cannot control, because of lack of wisdom and knowledge about energies. Spirituality is something totally different. It has to do with the use of real universal love energy and wisdom from the source of light. Spiritual growth, wisdom and knowledge is coming only through the experience and understanding of many lives. That is a natural way, so you will not do any mistakes that create negative karma. It is not possible to force it with drugs. With drugs, you will lose and fall many lives back. You cannot go from the first grade in a learning class directly to the highest. You have to go through all the classes one by one in order to understand knowledge and gain wisdom. Only in this way you will not make any mistakes. Drugs have no benefits. They actually are blocking your spiritual growth, and when you die, you are stuck in the lower negative worlds with demons for a long time until you get rid of this negative energy. You can only go to the higher realms with a high, clean, spiritual cosmic energy of light and love. Only then your soul, your energy body, can stand the higher energies of higher dimensions. This is higher spiritual science and has nothing to do with belief systems. When the brain and nerves are damaged with poison from smoking and alcohol, it cannot hold higher frequencies of light, and therefore negative entities can penetrate the weak aura of the addicted and manipulate the behavior. Your body is the temple of your soul. If your brain is not functioning right, your soul cannot work with your physical brain properly. A damaged radio cannot receive clear music, but only distorted noise or nothing. In the higher realms, you cannot stay with a dirty soul. The energy is too high there. There's a natural security border at the higher realms to make sure that no evil energy can pass through. One of the most important life lessons is to learn to be free from limitations. We are the source of our own prosperity. Abundance is a part of the source. If you reject this part, you are rejecting the source too. The source, the cosmic awareness, does not tell you to be poor or limited. Only the church, the governments, bankers, or envy negative people want you to be poor, limited, and controllable. If you are grateful for the service of others, you will attract abundance too. If you are happy for the success of others, you will attract abundance too. If you are jealous or envy because others are successful, you will block your own abundance flow. Because with negative thinking, you are telling the existence that you don't want abundance. And even more worse is when you insult and attack somebody who is successful, or somebody who is doing efforts to be successful. Success is nothing bad. Just because some negative people have misused their success, that does not mean that success is bad. It depends on how we use success. If we create positive karma, we create abundance in all parts of our life. If you have created negative karma in the past lives or in this life by stealing or blocking the abundance of somebody, the energetic result of this is to experience a blockade of abundance too. Karma is the natural universal principle of cause and effect. In order to heal this negative karma, you have to create positive karma by helping others to gain abundance. Everything is energy, and yes, even money is energy. If we use the energy money for spiritual purposes, we can create a society without money. Money is not bad, it's neutral energy that is part of a life lesson. It depends on how we use the energy called money. Money is a learning lesson of how to use it for positive things. The physical money is just a tool to learn. You can use money spiritually to create wellness for others. As long as money exists on Earth, we have to use it for spiritual purposes. If we use the energy money for spiritual purposes, we can create a society without money. We have to allow the money to serve us for the benefit of everybody. Abundance should be flowing to everybody, just like it is the case on higher developed planets. If you keep money for selfish and greedy purposes, you create negative karma. You have to find the middle way of using it for spiritual and useful things for yourself and others without being addicted or possessed by it. With money, you can thank others for their help or work. If I want somebody to repair my car, I have to pay him for his service. In that way, I thank him for his service, and because of that, I attract abundance too. That is spiritual behavior. If somebody don't want to pay a bill for the service of somebody else, it shows that he don't appreciate the effort of others and rejects the physical reality. That is closing the root chakra, and abundance cannot flow. Money is an energetic training in the lower dimensions to learn to appreciate and honor the work, the service of others. If you do so, you change your energy and you start to receive abundance too, and your consciousness is ready for higher dimensions. In higher dimensions, we don't have money. We can create everything we want with our thoughts because we are using our energy and abundance to help everybody. We are sharing everything with others, and we don't have egoistic thinking. Everybody lives in the service for the others. As long as money exists on Earth, you have to be thankful for the essence of what you are paying. If you pay for the phone, the essence of it is communication. If you pay for the car, the essence of it is mobility. If you pay for music CDs, the essence of it is the energy and the feeling that you get that makes you feel good. We have to be thankful for the essence and the main energy that we get. That is the spiritual lesson. The more gratitude you have, the more abundance and happiness you attract. The more jealousy, ego, or hate you have for others, the more you're pushing yourself in misery and stagnation, and your root chakra is blocked. The existence, the cosmic awareness, is always giving abundance in many different ways. But many Earth humans are blocking and rejecting this with their negative thoughts and behavior they got from the Earth society, or with negative karma from many past lives. If you have a negative attitude towards abundance and wealth, you have to ask yourself, am I allowing myself to receive abundance in life, or do I block it with my negative thinking? Do I attack successful people because I'm jealous, or am I happy for the success of others? Am I open to receive abundance from the existence, or am I blocking it? If you are in tune with the existence, you create abundance energy, and you will receive help and abundance from other people or situations that you did not expect, because your root chakra is creating abundance energy. Program your mind with these positive affirmations. I have the potential to live in abundance. I can feel the energy of abundance is improving my life. I know that I am in tune with the energy of abundance. I know that abundance is a natural energy of the existence of the Source. I am looking forward to receive all the abundance of the existence. I am open to receive all the abundance of the existence. Schizophrenia. If somebody suffers of schizophrenia, it is a sign that this person is manipulated, possessed, and disturbed by people or entities from the lower astral dimension. These can be evil demonic entities or dead people who can't find the light because they were always living negative. Those people in the lower astral dimension were people who were living with wrong, distorted energies like haters, smokers, suicide people, murderers, manipulators, or similar people with disturbed and twisted energies. Those entities are trying to steal energy of other people, and they like to control and manipulate others. A person that is manipulated by those people needs a powerful cosmic light energy to get free of those entities. So they need the help and light energy of others too, for a long period of time, until every negative energy is cleansed. If you meditate and send them a powerful light, they could use it to free themselves. Negative entities in the lower dimensions are afraid of cosmic spiritual light. They feed mostly from negative energies like fear, anger, arrogance, ego, or perversions. So you have to send them a powerful light filled with love energy, just as I say in all my videos. In that way, you free a person from the possession and at the same time, you give the negative entities the opportunity to find the light. With the same energy, you can protect yourself from attacks from entities or people from the lower astral dimension. Tourette syndrome. The Tourette syndrome, or twitching, is caused by an imbalance in the body energy. The light energy flow in the body is disturbed, and the nerves are not functioning correctly. This could be a sign for a possession from negative entities or fears, or having the feeling of being watched all the time. Now that we are charged with the natural higher frequencies of DION and the mountain Olympus, let us use this energy to heal ourselves and the Earth society. We need positive energy in order to heal the cause, the reason, the root of our physical or mental disease. I'm sitting here at a natural waterfall and pool on Mountain Olympus. The water flow is increasing the natural energy of the mountain. Imagine that you sit with me right in front of the waterfall and try to feel the energy of the mountain and the nature. Imagine how the water stream flows through your body energetically and it's flushing negative energies away. It will clean your aura and it will charge all your energy bodies with a higher frequency of cosmic light and love. Meditation is a state of mind, a state of consciousness that you have to use in daily life in order to fulfill your life plan. Meditation is energy food for your soul. Just like your physical body on this physical dimension needs physical food. Meditation is not a hobby that you use only on some weekends. This will not create enough energy. Meditation energy has to be built up in a powerful level in order to be able to use it for changing situations in life. Sit in a comfortable, soft chair where you can relax all parts of your body. Don't make any strange contortions from blocking belief systems of planet Earth. Meditation is supposed to be relaxing and happy, and not a self-torture or some kind of extreme gymnastic. Even on higher developed planets, we are meditating in natural, relaxing positions. One day I took a picture of a meditating cat that was feeling the energy of the nature. This is a perfect example of the state of mind you should be in a meditation. Breathe in 3 times, very deep and slow. And each time you breathe in, imagine that you drink the cosmic light energy into your body. See how the cosmic light energy is cleaning your body and your aura. Now breathe out and blow away any bad energy, any negative thoughts, any negative feelings that are blocking you to concentrate. Blow all unnecessary energies out and let them disappear. Each time you're doing this, you're getting brighter and brighter. You're filling your body with pure, white, loving light. It is the brilliant light of the source, the consciousness of the existence. The light is getting bigger and bigger, and you are covered in a big glowing light ball. Feel the peace, the wisdom, and the love of the source, the cosmic awareness. Feel how your heart is getting warm and powerful. See how all your chakra energy points are being activated and harmonized. Now repeat mentally these words. I am in tune with the energy of the cosmic awareness. I allow the cosmic light to heal me. I program the cosmic light with the property, wisdom, and healthiness. The energy of the cosmic light helps me to understand what thoughts or emotions have created the disease. Now think for a moment. What kind of negative energy has caused the disease or negative situation? Go back to the energetic root of the problem and see what negative energy, thought, or emotion has created it. When you have understood the energetic cause of the problem, say to yourself, I understand what negative thoughts or emotions are used to make me sick. I want to heal all energetic blockades, even those that I have created in past lives. I allow the cosmic love energy of the cosmic awareness to heal my blockades from all my past lives and from the current life. From now on, I will use positive thoughts and emotions to keep my body and mind healthy. From now on, I will use cosmic love energy in my heart and consciousness in my daily life. From now on, I'll allow only cosmic love energy to guide my thoughts, emotions, and actions. I will apologize to all persons that I caused harm, either mentally or physically, with my thoughts or actions. Visualize how the cosmic light of the source is healing the situation that you want to heal. Concentrate on the part of your body that needs healing. Or concentrate on a negative situation that you want to heal. And see how the bright light of the cosmic awareness is healing you. Feel it in your body working. Now say mentally, I am grateful for the healing energy of the nature. I am grateful for the healing energy of the cosmic central consciousness. I am grateful for the understanding and wisdom. I am grateful for the energy of love and healing. From now on, I will radiate the cosmic love energy of the source. From now on, I have only positive thoughts and emotions. From now on, I promise that I will act as a real lightworker without ego or arrogance. Cosmic Awareness, thank you for your light, energy and guidance. I am one with the Cosmic Awareness. I am in tune with the cosmic energy of light and love. Universal cosmic love is the meaning of life. Cosmic love is the solution for everything. Don't miss to watch all the previous episodes of my movie series, Cosmic Love is the Solution for Everything. Each time you're watching them, you gain more knowledge and wisdom, and you receive the embedded frequencies of light from higher dimensions. This will help you to develop cosmic love in your heart and consciousness. It will help you to master your life and be a healing, loving light for others.